Hi, this is Randy Finney with Right Side of the Chart, and today is Tuesday, May 3rd, 2016. I had a message sent to me, private message from a member of the site who asked about my nugget short trade. I posted that as an unofficial or just something I was doing in the trading room. That's certainly an extremely aggressive catch a falling knife trade, or really in reverse, you catch a, I guess, catch a rising knife, you want to say, if you're shorting something that's going nearly straight up. As we all know, GDX has been nearly parabolic recently. It had a near vertical rip off the lows in January into this consolidation area. It went sideways for a few months, as gold did, and then broke out of there, and it's gone up in almost a near vertical fashion since. And on a scale of 1 to 10, that I'm sure most would consider that a 10, as far as aggressiveness, just what might appear to be just a blind pot shot at it. But however, I made the case, so I'm not going to do the entire case. The recent video coverages that I've put out, I made the case for a pullback in gold in the miners. So particularly in the mining sector, more so, more bullish, bearish on that, I should say, near term for a pullback than gold itself. But with that being said, when trading anything, I especially something like a sector ETF that's pegged to an underlying, in other words, GDX will go where gold goes ultimately, and there are some temporary disconnects. But so when trading the miners, I always keep one eye, a close eye on the charts of gold and on the U.S. dollar, which also, in one way or another, often affects the price of gold. So in other words, if what I'm seeing on the charts of gold is not confirming what I'm seeing on GDX, and if what I'm seeing on the dollar isn't confirming what I'm seeing on gold, with trading, you almost have to try to talk yourself out of a trade. And that's the way, instead of trying to talk yourself into a trade, I find it better to try to talk yourself out of a trade. And if you can't make a strong enough case against it, then you go ahead with it. Of course, make the case initially, but I'm saying then look at other supporting factors and make sure they either confirm, and if too many of those factors refute the trade or go against it, then it's not worth it. So, where I'm going with this, that's my plan, is to watch how everything develops here. Yesterday I was able to, short darn near the highs, start out a position. And here's what I'm watching so far. We're looking at a 60-minute chart, and this is a pretty key level here. GDX, especially when the momentum traders are in it, trades very well to the technicals, meaning off what you're seeing on the charts. A lot of traders watching the same levels. Gaps are like magnets. I've drawn a few out here. You can see there's a gap right here. Well, first it's this gap I'm watching, and you can see that we reversed right about almost in the middle, close to the bottom of that gap so far today. Now my plan is, I can wait for a break of that level, in which case I would short if we went below this lower line, which is at 24.35. I would likely add to my position. However, I'd almost prefer, or I will tell you, I prefer to short on a bounce. I like to get, better entries on my prices, average down if we get a bounce here to anywhere up to or near this line right here, 25.49. I'd be shorter a little bit before that, and I can always place my stops not too far, really just above yesterday's highs. Because if I'm right, and I may be right, but just a couple days early, and I get stopped out, that's fine. I can always re-enter again. The case, the still, the longer term case I made on the daily chart would not go away, even if GDX just went ahead and popped a little bit above that level now. So how much room I want to give it, I'll have to look. But I would tell you it wouldn't be too far above the recent highs. Maybe a 60-minute close right up there above 20, 28, what is it? 26.30. All right, so ideally a little bounce here, because so far everything I'm seeing is confirming this short entry, is confirming that the miners are likely to reverse. Sure, they're down today, but that's minuscule in the scheme of things. It's, 1 point, what is that? 1.85, less than 2% drop. Not a whole big deal. Now we were down a little lower before, but that's neither here nor there. Point is, GDX can go up or down 5% in a day, and if things get ugly, it's going to go down 4 or 5% in the next week or so here. At least one day, I'd imagine. All right, so these are all support levels. Now you can see, going back to the gaps, here's a gap right here. We can draw these out. Let me grab some tools here. So we've got a gap here. We have a gap right here. And you can see in a reaction high here. So there's a nice support level. That's just below that trend line. This would be your next bearish or sell signal. Break of this down uptrend line right here, and as well as a break below that trend line there, or horizontal line, I should say, which is at 23.14. I have it at. Here's another one at 22.38. Now, at this point, I wouldn't be shorting anymore because I'll be getting ready to cover, and I'll show you why in a minute. But you can see again, reaction low, gap. Some reactions in there. So again, these are pretty well-defined levels, any of which could be, bounce targets, just as this was here. We've had an intraday reversal so far. Price is moving off the, really, if I look at what I like to do on gaps, some people consider this the bottom of the gap, as it technically is. I always look to a reaction high or low nearby that gap. So that would be, you can see the reaction high right there. That's what I consider the bottom of the gap. Those are the levels that I watch. I don't know what other traders do, but I've seen that, and I know most people, and technically that is the bottom of the gap, the top of this candlestick here, the day before prices gapped up. But again, that's my, I often put that on, you'll notice on the trade ideas, those are the levels I watch, the reaction highs nearby that gap. And I believe that occurred on the same day. That was, actually, that was Thursday. Yeah, that was Thursday's high. So on a daily candlestick, that would appear to be the top of the gap. So I should have clarified that. All that for nothing. But sometimes you don't see that. Sometimes there might have been a couple days price action again. So let's just say Thursday's high was there, but we had a little bit higher high over here on Wednesday or Tuesday. That would have been the reaction high I'd be looking at. So that was a gap backfill. Perfect. You can see that. I mean, right off that level. And so what you want to do is not add here. That's not an objective short entry. If you wanted to take a shot at a short entry up here with a stop not too far above, that was objective. Adding just before support is anything but objective. Waiting for a break of support. Now, as I often say, the initial tag of support from above often produces a reaction. That's the initial tag, the first tag. Next time, if my analysis is right, that level goes. So again, I'd like to get a little higher up here, maybe even around 25. I might add a little bit to it. And again, I'll go through the charts. I'm doing that now. And after I wrap up this video, I'll study that and determine where and when to add a little bit more. Here's that uptrend line, as I said. Certainly on a break of that, there would be an objective entry. And then this is a pretty solid resistance. I'm sorry, support level. But ultimately, my target is right here. So I want to be adding up around this level, anywhere objective. This area here. When we get close to, halfway or beyond to where my preferred target is, that starts to be what I call no man's land. It's harder to time an entry and not be caught in a counter trend bounce, that might go up here and then put that position underwater or your entire position at that fact. So, target wise, let's take a look at that. I mentioned some of my targets in the trading room today. What I'm eyeing is this trading range that we were in. This is the trading range that we were in for most of pretty much from that was February, late February all the way till we finally broke out of there in early April. So a 2 month trading range. Even before we got up into this sideways trading range here, you can see prices. We had several reactions from below. Broke into it. That level then, which is just FYI, that's about 1890 or so, that acted as support for quite a while. The top end of the range was resistance. Finally, we broke out with a gap, came to back test it, validating that support level now. Former resistance becomes support. And as such, my target is my pullback target is that level, or at least where the support level where I think GDX is going. Now, the important thing is GDX and gold have all the makings of being in the early stages of a new bull market following a vicious bear market that just ended in, for gold in December and for the mining stocks in January. As such, you don't want to stay late to the party if you're doing counter trend trades. In other words, if you're shorting pullbacks when gold or GDX runs into resistance, oversold, everything else confirms. Because pullbacks, especially on an early stage bull market, often get bought up a lot faster and sooner than where people expect. So if all eyes are watching this level and you have a 38.2 fib, that's of the entire run off the January lows up to the recent highs, that's a solid support level. You don't want to set your stop, your buy to cover limit orders right there to cover your short position, because the buyers may step in early. So, I plan to cover a little bit above that area. There's also a gap right there. There's also a reaction low right there. And that's that. Now, with all that being said, if depending on how the charts develop, because I'm going to just touch on the dollar here, if you're still with me, we'll look at the dollar and gold in a second. Sometimes, if all eyes are expecting one thing, if all eyes are looking at this, well, let's just get rid of that trend line. I already went over that. And looking for a pullback to this level, because that was that big, well-defined support level or sideways trading range for the last couple of months, then the market has an uncanny way of surprising the masses. So maybe GDX just smashes right through there like it wasn't even there. Doesn't even give you a reaction, a nice tradable bounce off the top of there. Could even go down below there, shoot right through the whole trading range. It's a possibility. Again, I don't see a lot in the price and momentum indicators and oscillators. These usually do a good job at times of telling me where things might be going, but if I don't see anything there, then I'm not going to try to force it. Daily chart, let's look at gold, GDX. There's that very steep bearish rising wedge, and I like to say the steeper the wedge, the more violent the downside break. So my expectation is for a swift move down and to just above this 2120-ish area. There's that sideways consolidation for the last couple months, and cover above there. But I, one thing that is keeping me open to the possibility of doing an alternative strategy. Of lowering stops, trailing down a relatively tight stop, or lowering stops. Let's just say when we cross below that 2240 area, which is this reaction low in the bottom of that gap, that's a very, very solid level there. Let's say we get there, and that may be the stopping point. So at that point, I tighten up stops. I put a relatively tight stop just above there. So if we reverse and keep going up, then I've made a few bucks and nothing, nothing lost on the trade. However, that I could let the position continue to ride and continue to trail the stops down from that point. And if it smashes through this level and keeps going, maybe to the bottom of that range, I mean, you're talking, that's a pretty big percentage drop in GDX. And if you're trading Nugget, now given Nugget's adjusted for the leverage anyway, so it's all washed. That's about, call it a 27% drop in GDX, or a 20, 70, 80% drop in one third position of Nugget. It's all the same. So that's a possibility, and things could get even uglier from there. I'm not looking for that right now, but I am open to that possibility. Why? Because of this daily chart. This negative divergence. We don't see negative divergence very often on a daily time frame. It only happens usually at most once a year or so. Especially you can see we haven't had negative divergence on GDX in over 2 years that this chart spans here. Well, I stand corrected. Right around the end of the 2 year mark, there was a divergent high right here on the daily time frame. But you get my point, and you see what happened after that divergent high. Negative divergence with a bearish rising wedge. These are my kind of patterns. So early stage bull market behavior or not, we could have a very healthy correction. Lasting several weeks or more, and one of the reasons I like to short Nugget, even if, let's just assume that we pull back here and we get back in this trading range, or we just bounce around the top of it for a few months. That decay, especially in the miners, because they swing so much up and down day to day, it's vicious. And even if the miners went nowhere for a couple months, I would make money on a Nugget short almost certainly just from the decay alone. So again, so setting a stop. If the charts continue to firm up and really indicate that we might be in for a multi-week, maybe even a multi-month pullback in the sector, that puts shorting Nugget in my favor. Here's UUP. Let's look at it on a 2 hour chart. That looks a little better. This is the dollar ETF. As I mentioned in the trading room today and on one of the videos recently, bullish divergences in place. You can see the RSI and the MACD either make an equal low or a higher low here versus price is clearly making a lower low. That really should match up that. You can see it matches where the MACD and the RSI peaked out. So there's your divergent low, which isn't just random that happened to come here. Well, it doesn't show well on UUP is in a it's an ETF, so you're not going to have the you're not going to have the it's not going to track as well as the actual index. This is a DYXO, the dollar index. You can see we had that little intra-week punch through, so I allow for sometimes a little temporary break of support. We still have bullish divergences in place on the daily time frame. As I mentioned clearly, I'm longer term bearish on the dollar. I think that level goes. However, we have the divergence in place. We had this recent wedge. This looks like a breakout and a back test with an overshoot. The dollar was up pretty nice today. It had a nice reversal. And this is an end of day index there you're looking at on the DXY. The dollar, UUP is an ETF, so it just shows you the dollar's trading up today. And again, the case was made there on a 60-minute chart with the bullish divergences, 2-hour chart. So when we go back to that DXY chart, which again, this will be updated tonight, and that'll show us moving back up. So far, the dollar's up, and that would be a great bear trap too for dollar bears. If that breakdown of that well-defined level, and it would do the same for gold. Rising dollar is not beneficial for gold. There's the negative divergences on gold. Gold took out that recent reaction high, at least in GLD, and would likely fall back if the dollar bounces, puts in a significant bounce. Gold's going to fall back, and this would be my minimum target. So again, I'm watching all of these things together, and at this point, I'm favoring a move down only to that level I mentioned on GDX, the top of that trading range. But I'm open to the possibility of more, and sometimes I'll do that. I'll by covering right if and when we get there, what that does, and that's often how I trade, it just gets me out of the trade, lets me move on to the next one. The risk reward to remaining short is no longer very attractive at that point. That's usually why I have those profit targets, and I just take the money and run. Sometimes they continue on. Very often they reverse. However, once in a while, if the case can be made for much bigger gains, I give back a little by instead of covering down here just above support by setting my stop, either trailing a stop or setting it a little bit overhead. Sure, that allows some give back on your profits, but it could keep you in for the big hit. Instead of hitting a double or a triple here, you can hit a home run or a grand slam if things really got ugly in the mining sector, which again, at this point, I'm not really favoring that, but I am open to the possibilities. So hopefully this helps. And again, I know a lot of it's confusing. There are a lot of moving parts, and that's, at times I have very clear, well-defined trading plans, says buy here, sell here, no ifs, ands, or buts. There's other times that, because the markets are dynamic, so is my analysis and my trading plan. And that's right now, at least what I outlined is my current plan for the gold trade or GDX nugget short. Okay, this has been Randy Finney with Right Side of the Chart. Hope you enjoyed.